It gives me so much honor and delight to introduce this amazing lady, Chani Peach, Chani Carosso, Chani Thompson. Gosh, I love her so much. She came into this business very big-eyed, very hopeful, but she'd tell you she probably wasn't my best prospect. And getting to witness someone just grow and grow and grow to the person that you see in front of you. This is someone who has won Partner of the Year. She's spoken on global stages for this profession. She has a huge heart that goes well beyond her and her team. Her aspiration is really to make network marketing a household name, something that people are proud of, something that's not misunderstood anymore. And so watching her and her husband, Matt, build this incredible organization that's global, it's such an honor to have her on the stage to finish this conference. And so I'm gonna have you upstanding and to remain upstanding as we welcome Chani to the stage.
Hello. Before you sit down, I just want to ask you to do something with me, please. I would love everybody here to just take a really big breath in with me. Ready? How good does that feel? Okay, you can sit down. Thank you so much, guys. I just want to first of all say that it is an absolute honor to be closing out conference today. I'm so proud to be a part of this profession, and I'm so proud to be a part of this company. How incredible is what this company has put on for us this weekend and the bonuses that are coming. Are you guys excited for that? That was a very kind introduction, and I love you. Thank you so much. It's always really nice to have your highlight reel put forward, but I'm really mindful that the person who stands before you today is actually someone who very often doubts herself and questions her ability to lead and do what it is that I'm here to do. And honestly, there have been so many moments of, can I do this and what if I fail? But when I look back on my life and I look at all the accolades and the achievements and the business that I've created, the team that I am so grateful to have, there's actually one thing that has made a big difference, and it's a formula that I've created. And I'm going to share that formula with you today. Now, I have to be honest with you, this formula, it contains a secret in it, and I didn't make up this secret. This secret is ancient wisdom. It's been passed down for thousands and thousands of years. I've just created it into a easy-to-follow formula so that we don't forget it today. But I think for you to understand how that formula even came to be is for me to take you back to where it all began. 6 years ago, I was a registered nurse, and I was broke. I was putting $5 of fuel in my car at a time. I was giving myself a $50 note for groceries before the next payday, and I was gifting myself $20 to go and do something fun, like an avocado on toast or a smoothie or something, which is about $20. And so I was in a really scary financial situation. I had a maxed out credit card that I couldn't afford to pay. I was just getting by. I was just making ends meet, if that. There was more month at the end of my money. And I was really stressed. I honestly didn't know how I was going to survive the next week. And I was earning a pretty good income as a registered nurse, but it just wasn't enough. It wasn't allowing me to live a life that I had envisioned. So I went to a money mindset course because I was trying to figure out, how do I get myself out of this situation? I'm a grown adult, yet I am always in the red. And so I went to a money mindset course, and next to me, I sat next to a friend now, who was a chiropractor. And we had a quick chat. We had to do a little game or an activity where we had to play, tell each other what we did. And so we quickly realized that we had a lot in common. He was a chiropractor, I was a nurse. We really loved health. And so we stayed connected. And later on, a few weeks later, Anthony, who just introduced me on stage, reached out to me and said, "Hey, look, I've got something that I think you would really love, and I'd love to collaborate with you. I think we could create some magic." I was in survival mode at that time. I was already working 40 to 50 hours a week, and the thought of adding something else to my plate just didn't seem realistic. And so I said no. I actually said no to this business for 6 months. And it wasn't until one day I was on my way to work. I used to commute to Brisbane, so it took me an hour. And I was at the petrol station putting fuel in my car. And I remember thinking, I've only got $5. I just need to put $5 of fuel in my car so I can get to work. That'll get me back. I'll figure it out tomorrow how I'll get to work. So I'm standing at the Bowser. I've got the fuel going into my car. And I don't know if you've ever been in survival mode before, but you just space out. And I just wasn't paying attention. And all of a sudden, I look at the Bowser, and it's well and truly over $5. And I remember thinking, I don't know how I'm going to pay for this. My parents had owned petrol stations all through my high school, so I knew the process. I knew that when someone couldn't afford or pay for fuel, you had to go in, you had to leave valuables like a credit card or a phone or keys, and I was in a rush. I had to get to work. So I remember walking into the petrol station, tail in between my legs, and I remember just saying, I can't pay for this right now, but I promise I'll be back. My mum and dad own petrol stations, and I know what this is like, and I'm so sorry. And I just remember feeling so embarrassed. So I did what I had to do. I walked out to my car, and I remember getting into my car, putting the seatbelt on, turning the ignition on, putting my hands on the steering wheel, and just bursting into tears because I couldn't believe that I was a 27-year-old adult and couldn't freaking afford $5 of fuel. And so here I am 6 years later. I said yes to Anthony because I remember driving to work that day thinking, I don't know what else to do. I can't physically work more than I'm working now. And so I decided to say yes to this business to see what could this create for me? And I'm so grateful that I did because it's been the most beautiful journey that I have been on. I ended up joining in December 2015, and I can't tell you how beautiful this journey has been. And so what I want to do today is I want to give you all clarity. I want to give you a blueprint. I want to give you certainty that there is a winning formula that works. I promise, if you follow it, it works. But here's the thing. The secret that I'm about to share with you, you'll only grasp it if you're ready. There are people in this room who are ready for success, and there are people here that are at a point in their life where they're not ready yet, kind of like me when I met Anthony at that money mindset course. I wanted it, but I wasn't ready. So let me tell you something here today. What I'm about to share with you, the secret will stand out for you if you're ready for it. So pay attention, pay very close attention. I'm not going to name it. It doesn't have a name. I can't give it to you. You have to grab it. And what I want to say to you is, if you see it, if you acknowledge it, just take a moment and just have a little prayer of gratitude of, oh, there it is. I don't know when you're going to see the secret. You might see it in the first 10 minutes. You might see it in the last second of my presentation today. But I promise that this winning formula that I'm about to share with you is going to help you. It's the secret to getting paid for success. Okay, so are you guys ready to hear my formula? All right, let's do this. Okay, so what I've done, what I'll explain, I should say, is when we have a goal, when we have a desire, we don't just rock up. We don't just appear there and wing it, right? We have to reverse engineer our goals, which means that we look forward to whatever it is that we want to create, and then we work our way backwards. We start to make little baby steps, and we understand that there's a roadmap of what it is that we have to do. So what I'm going to do is, just going to get it up. I'm going to show you this formula that I call PAID. But we're going to be ascending from D up to P, just so that you remember, whenever you set a goal, you have to work backwards, okay? You have to reverse engineer that. And so I'm going to start with D, and we're going to work our way, and I want you to pay close attention, because there's going to be quizzes in this, okay? I'm going to be quizzing y'all. Okay, so let's start with D, desire and decision. What is desire and decision? It's when you decide that you're so ready for whatever it is that you want to create in your life, and you go all in. It is when it becomes this obsession with your life, a deep desire. It's not hope. It's not a wish. It's not, I'll give it a go and I'll see and I might try. It's none of that. It is certain. It is done. And so there's no such thing as going back or changing your mind. Success comes to those who make the desire and the definite goal that whatever it is that they want is going to occur no matter what. Success comes when you have willpower, when you have energy, when you have passion, when you're excitable. And so when you stand with that desire and you agree with yourself, you make a pact that no matter what, it is becoming an obsession with your life, that is where success begins. That is where the seed is planted. Anthony calls it success, obsessed with success. I wish I could coin that. I can't, it's not mine. But you burn all the bridges to the possibility of quitting. You burn all the bridges to possibly turning back. So, let's repeat that again. It becomes a consuming obsession of your life. Second, it is definite. Third, you attain a burning desire. It's all you think about. It's all you talk about. You wake up thinking about it. You go to sleep thinking about it. And you claim the decision of its purpose. And quitting is not an option. So, let me tell you a really cool story. I was thinking about, where did I learn to have decision and desire? And I have this vivid memory. I was in year two. Now, just a little backstory. English is my second language. I actually speak fluent Spanish. My parents are from Uruguay. They migrated here into Australia. They met here. They had me. And then I was taught how to speak Spanish growing up. And so when it was time for me to go to school, I then had to learn how to speak English. So some of my words that I knew my first day of kindy was toilet, please, and thank you. So I was an ESL kid. I don't know if you know what that is, but an ESL kid is English second language. I couldn't read and I couldn't write. I couldn't speak very well either. So I was always the kid that was being plucked out of class and being taught how to read and write separate from the other children. And so I was bullied, I was always pointed at and laughed at for that. So I remember going to a brand new school in year two, and I didn't have any friends yet. And my mum and dad came to school that day because there was a cross-country carnival. And this is one of the earliest memories of my childhood. I remember there was the big oval, and there were these big tents, and there was loud music, and I was nervous, but I didn't know why. I hadn't played sport before. I'd never run before. And I remember my mum and dad coming to me and saying, "Chani, you're going to have to run around the oval, and then there's a hill. You have to go over the hill, and then you've got to go down the hill, and then you've got to go around the big oak tree, and then you come back, and that's the race done." I remember going, "Okay, I can do that." So I'm at the finish, at start line, and that gun goes off, and I'm running. Like, I'm like, "Oh my gosh, okay, got to go around the hill, got to go up the tree, got to do all the things." Now, I remember getting to the hill, and I remember the hill was big. Like, I think I was about this big. And I'm looking at the hill, and I'm like, "Okay, that's massive." I run up the hill, I go around, and I come back down. And one thing I remember vividly was these little pegs all along the way, and the pegs had these little red flags. And I remember being told, "Just run between the pegs and you won't get lost." So I'm following the pegs, and I'm running, and I'm running up that hill, and I'm getting out of breath. And then I get to the top, and I'm like, "That was hard, but I'm here, it's all good." I start to run down the hill, and all of a sudden I start to gain this momentum, and I'm running really fast. And then I look around, and there's no one around me. And all of a sudden, I think, "I'm coming last. I got to keep running." So I keep running. I go around the oval, and I do the oak tree. I do it all. And I remember coming back to that last little 200-meter sprint. And there's my mum and dad, just down the back there. And I'm running with all my might. And I catch up to some kids. I don't know who they are. And I cross the finish line. And my mom comes over to me, and she's like crying. She's like, "You just won that race." And I'm like, "Yes, I don't know what that means." And I got a little ribbon, and I'm just like, you know, superstar, like, yes. But the reason I want to tell you this story is because my mom and dad never told me to win. They just told me to finish. And I remember making a decision in that race that I was not going to not finish that race. I remember the hill. It was really hard. I remember coming back down. All of a sudden, I have momentum. And I couldn't help but think that run is just like our business, isn't it? I've lost something on my dress. It's around here somewhere. I don't know. So the magic is in the process, okay? The magic is not in the destination. The magic is in the journey there. So make that decision to go all in and throw everything you've got at it. And that desire to get what it is that you want is so important. It's such an integral part to this business journey, not just this business journey, but to life in general. So tell me, what does D stand for? I found it. Desire and decision. Good, you're paying attention. Awesome. Okay, I. Now, before I tell you what the next part of the formula is, I need to see a raise of hands. Who has had a desire to win or to achieve a goal and they've made the decision to go all in, but they've just been met with resistance? Yeah, me too. I stands for imagination. Now, let me tell you a little bit about imagination. We have discovered that our brains are both a broadcasting and receiving system. It's very cool. It's like your vibration of thought attracts, magnetizes in exactly what is happening in your life. Look around you. You have created this. Look to the person next to you. You created that person in your reality. Now, without getting too woo on you and getting down the rabbit hole of quantum physics, just understand that we are naturally in creation mode. We are creative beings. And so what you think about, you bring about. So what you can think of and what you can imagine, literally you can create out of nothing, out of thought, out of a desire impulse. Don't you think that's cool? So how do you convert desire into reality, into its physical form? Sounds a bit crazy. It's important to understand that when you make that desire and that decision and you imagine what your life could be like, you will be met with circumstances that are going to make you flex your imagination even more. And so what that means is you'll be met with adversity. You'll be met with challenges. Kind of like the universe testing you to see how badly you really want it. I call them universal assignments. So when you make a life-changing decision for something that will literally change your life, there's going to come a time where you not only need to imagine what you can create, but have faith that you can achieve it. So I'm going to be a little bit cheeky here and just throw another word in there, but I created this formula, so I can do that. So faith. Let me tell you a little bit about faith. I lost my faith this year. And I've only told my husband. In January 2020, for those of you who have been here for some time, you would have known that the company brought in 4 extra positions after NMD. IMD, EMD, PMD, PMD Plus. So in January 2020, we sort of were just plonked into whatever position our business was at the time. So I landed on PMD, Presidential Marketing Director. But I'm competitive and I want that plus. So just to give you a little bit of an idea of what that would have looked like for me, to hit PMD Plus, one of the requirements is you must have $500,000 worth of Juice Plus going through your business in one calendar month. That's $500,000. I was $80,000 off. And prior to January 2020, I could have done that in 3 months, 4 months maximum. I looked at that and I was like, I have got this in the freaking bag. So January comes, then February comes, then March comes, and I'm still not there. Now, I'm an Aries A-type overachiever, very competitive with myself, not anyone else. So I'm starting to get frustrated. I'm like, why isn't this working? I could do this with my eyes closed. And I know I'm sounding like a little bit of a spoiled brat, but I was pissed. And so then June comes, July, August, September, October, November, December, January 2021. It's been a year now since PMD Plus is available, and I'm still not there. February comes, March comes, and I lost faith. I can't really tell you the feeling, but it's kind of like you do everything you think will work and you're just met with resistance. It's like nothing's working. Maybe I'm not good enough. Maybe I'm missing the point. Maybe I need to learn how to be a better leader. Maybe I need to change my calendar. Maybe I need to get a coach. Maybe I need to get an assistant. Maybe, like, I'm telling you, I tried everything under the sun and nothing worked. And I remember this day vividly. It was on a Thursday and Maddie and I were walking my dog and he could tell something was up. And I just remember it was the first time I said it out loud. I was just like, I've lost my faith. I don't think I can do it. Like, it's just not possible. And then that was like the first time I had said it out loud, and I said, I've lost faith in the universe. I'm not feeling guided. I'm just being met with resistance and I don't know what to do. And Maddie being Maddie, you know, gave me a little pep talk and did his amazing thing that he does. And I remember just getting back from my morning walk and I just thought, I've just got to chill. So I sat on the hill watching the waves roll in. And I just remember being like, I'm too smart to be so stupid. And so I gave myself a kick up the butt and I got on with my day. But here's the thing. You make the decision, you have the desire, you imagine it, but faith is such an integral part. And so this is a poem out of a book that I'm going to share with you today, eventually. But this is a poem out of a book that helped me that day. And it reads like this. If you think you are beaten, you are. If you think you dare not, you don't. If you like to win, but you think you can't, it is almost certain you won't. If you think you'll lose, you're lost. For out of this world we find, success begins with a person's will, it's all in the state of mind. If you think you're outclassed, you are. You've got to think high to rise. You've got to be sure of yourself before you can ever win a prize. Life's battles don't always go to the stronger or faster man. But sooner or later, the one who wins is the one who thinks he can. So what does I stand for? Tell me again, what does I stand for? I love it, my crowd is awake. Okay. The next is A. And what I'm about to share here, if you choose to take part of this formula seriously, this part will absolutely change your life. Action. Inspired action. Should have made that I, but whatever, roll with it. So we've learned that everything is created or that we want to acquire begins with a decision and a desire. We then throw everything we've got at it and go all in, and we imagine what's possible. We have faith that we can do it. Now you're going to be instructed to execute everything you've just put in place, to build the life of your dreams, to build what it is that you want to create, that you're dreaming of, and that is with inspired action. So I want to talk about something here that every single speaker has spoken about on stage. Every single speaker, I've been like, oh my God, this works with my formula. Wonderful. And it is consistency. Consistency overrides talent every day of the week. I'm going to say that again because I want you to write this down. Consistency overrides talent every day of the week. What I mean by that is it doesn't matter if you're not talented enough, or you think you're not, if you can't speak, if you can't write, if you can't read, if you're consistent, you will run laps around someone who's more talented than you. And I know this to be true. I can't read very well. I cannot write very well. My grammar is horrendous. My team know this. Every time I do a post, I've got the grammar police on my case. And believe it or not, I actually find it very hard to string sentences together in English. But I'm just consistent. I'm more consistent than most people. So consistency runs laps around talent every day of the week. And so what I want to say about this is when you take action, you must write a plan out. You must map it out. You have to have a blueprint. You have to have clarity, because a goal without a plan is a dead dream. And a plan without execution is simply just a delusion. Temporary defeat is not permanent failure. And this is such a, I love this one-liner. And the reason why is because when most people have the desire, they make the decision, they have the imagination, they have the faith, and then they fail, they quit. Hands up here who's seen some quitters in their time. Yeah. Pat on the back for you for not quitting. You're still here. Good on you. Do you want to know why most people fail and quit? Because they think it's meant to be easy. They think that it's just meant to be handed to them. They think that adversity and challenge isn't part of the equation. But let me tell you something. If you want to have your dream life, I'm talking a vision that is far beyond your expectations, far beyond what you can possibly imagine, you're going to come up against adversity and challenge. I mean, we've heard it today, right? We've heard it with absolutely every single speaker. And so the reason why most people fail is because instead of making a new plan and taking action on a new thing, they just quit. But what people don't realize is you have to make a plan, take action, fail, get up, try again, make another plan, take more action, fail, try again, and again and again and again. So permanent failure, that doesn't exist. It's just temporary defeat. Temporary defeat is literally just a feedback system. It's just saying to you, your plan wasn't good enough, take more action. So just keep this in mind. It's so important. Next time your plan fails, I just want you to remember that temporary defeat is not permanent failure. And a winner never quits and a quitter never wins. I love that line. Who here knows the story of the burning boats? Hands up. A few of you. Yes, Katie, you know this story. I heard this story from you. I'm going to read you this story. It's incredible, and it moved me the first time I saw it, heard it, read it. A long while ago, a great warrior had to make a decision which ensured his success on the battlefield. He was about to send his armies against a powerful foe whose men outnumbered his own. He loaded his soldiers into boats, sailed to the enemy's country, unloaded soldiers and equipment, then gave the order to burn the ships. Addressing his men before the first battle, he said, "You see those boats going up in smoke? That means we cannot leave these shores alive unless we win. Now we have no choice. We win or we perish." They won. Every person who wins in any undertaking must be willing to burn his ships and cut all sources of retreat. Only by doing so can one be sure of maintaining the state of mind known as a burning desire, the key to success. Now, the reason I love that story so much is because when I look back on the last 5.5 years, I can tell you I've had a burning desire. It's been hard. It's not been easy. There have been times where I've needed to lead when I'm the one who needed to be led. There have been times where I literally didn't think I could do it. There have been times where I've doubted my ability. But I've had this burning desire to never go back to that petrol station ever again. And so, if you want to be more than ordinary, then at some point, you're going to have to burn your ships. So what boat are you going to burn? I want you to think about it right now. What is the boat that you must burn? Because this is it. It's this. It's do or die. You can't go back. You can't quit. There's no way out. There's no escape plan. There's no exit door. People who live incredible lives, they just have willpower. They don't half-ass things. They just get it done. And they've got that burning desire. They focus on hard work and they sacrifice for it. They're willing to take risks. They're willing to throw everything they've got at it and go all in. And so I want to ask you today, what are you not fully committed to? Do you still have a boat there waiting for you just in case? What boat have you got to burn today? So, what does A stand for? Say it a little bit louder. What does A stand for? I love it. Cool. The last part to my formula, listen here. If you really are serious about creating the life of your dreams in every area of your life, and let me tell you something, paid doesn't mean paid financially. Paid means getting paid in joy, getting paid in fulfillment, getting paid in purpose, getting paid in happiness. And then it also means paying it forward. That's what I love about this industry. And that's what I love about this company. We're not in it just for ourselves. You get to a point where it becomes about everybody in your team. Kira spoke about it before, emotional revenue. It becomes about the people around you. It becomes about the people you want to help be stay-at-home moms or men who don't do a job they love anymore and get to do the projects that they do love. It's about helping people retire. You get to pay it forward with this formula. So yes, it could mean that you get paid financially. That's great. But what's more powerful is getting paid in fulfillment. Because success without fulfillment is not success. So the last part to my formula, if you really want to master this part and you really want to understand what it is that you need to create, if you take action on this next one, you'll cut a ball and chain off and blow your business up by 10-fold, 100-fold. I promise you, this works. I've tried it, I've tested it, and I also see incredible successful leaders in this room, and on observation, they have followed this part as well. Persistence. Have you guys heard that word more than once over this weekend? I have. When willpower and desire are mixed together, they make an irresistible pair. This is like the secret ingredient that makes a delicious story for success. But here's the thing I know. Most people, actually everyone who is successful, they're usually generalized as like ruthless or cold-hearted or blunt, straight to the point, but they're just misunderstood because let me tell you what, they just have something you don't and it's called willpower. And when you mix willpower with persistence, that, my friends, is such a beautiful ingredient for success. The basis of persistence is the power of will. What does that even mean? It just means you never give up. We heard Lauren's panel yesterday, and each and every single one of those women had persistence. And it was inspiring, right? Did that move you to your core? When I saw those women on stage talking about the persistence that they have endured, I was like, this is the secret to the formula. Part of it, anyway. You persist. So without persistence, you will be defeated before you even start. So you have to promise me this. This is something that you are going to practice. You can learn how to be persistent. You don't miss out on being persistent because of your past or your childhood or your situation. Persistence is just a decision. You can wake up one day and go, I am persistent. So no matter how slowly at first you have to move, with persistence comes success. So here's why I left this one last. There's no substitute for persistence. There really isn't. You're either persistent or you're not. It can't be supplemented with any other quality. You have to cultivate it. It has to be intrinsic. It has to be within you to want to go all in and never give up. It won't happen overnight, but it will happen one night. One of my beautiful team says that every single time I hear her on training, and I love it because that is the very essence of persistence. So you have to pass the universal assignments. The universe is going to test you. It's going to say, are you sure you really want that? Are you sure? How much do you really want that? The universe is going to put something in your path, and it's going to make you work hard for it. And you just have to say, I am persistent. I've got what it takes. I know I'm enough. I know I'm worthy. I know that consistency overrides talent every day of the week, and we just keep going. Persistence is just a state of mind. A definite purpose backed by a burning desire, that's persistence. An idea, a goal, or a dream that you're never letting go of, that's persistence. A plan of action that you continuously execute, even when you come across temporary defeat, that's persistence. A circle of influence who encourages you to keep going, that is really important for persistence. You have to surround yourself with people who've got your back. You are the average of the top 5 people you hang around. Have you guys heard that before? So if your daily coffee girl is in a grumpy mood every day and you see her every day of the week, guess what's going to happen? You are the average of the top 5 people you hang around. Create a circle of influence that has got your back, who believes in you, who are also persistent. When I see someone who's persistent, I'm like, I like you. I want you in my circle. I'm going to hang out with you every day of the week. It's so important. Who here knows the Truman Show? Yeah, show of hands. I need to see. Yeah, cool. I've got someone at the back like, yes. I love the Truman Show. It's one of my favorite movies. And there's a scene in the Truman Show that just reminds me of this business so much. So I'm going to play the Truman Show for you, just a little snippet, because I want you to see what I see. Let's play the video. So this is you just minding your own business. In your journey, you have a vision board. And you have that desire, and you have the decision, and you have the imagination. And you take action on your dreams. And just when you think everything's going right, the world starts to conspire against you.
How do we stop them? Okay, we're going to be accessing the weather program now. So hold on to your hats. You got that? No. I think we're going to want to localize the storm over the boat. You can get the coordinates for that.
There's no rescue boat he wouldn't want to do.
He'll turn back. He'll be too afraid.
There she blows.
And then you weather the storm. Your friends say something mean about you on social media. You finally get your first team member and then they block you out of nowhere. You reach out to your family and no one wants to support you. All your customers cancel. A work colleague Googles pyramid schemes and tells everyone in the tea room. Then one of your customers joins someone else's team. Then, just as you think it can't get any better, any worse.
Give me some lightning. Again. Hit him again.
The TGA sends you a letter. And just when you think you're not going to be able to survive this, you're at your wit's end.
God's sake, Chris. The whole world is watching. We can't let him die in front of a live audience. He was born in front of a live audience.
You decide to try one more time. And you get there. There's your team. There's your upline. And then you become a little bit delirious along the way. Very delirious.
Increase the wind.
Increase the wind!
And just when you think it can't get any worse.
I am telling you, for the last
how close is it? Very close.
Capsize him, tip him over.
Damn you, Victor!
No, you can't, his titan's up to the boat!
Shut up!
He's gonna drown, he doesn't even care.
Do it! Do it!
Feels like no one has your back. And then your biggest team leader leaves and joins another company. But you know what I love about this story? He survives. He weathers the storm and he creates his new reality. He changes his world. And that's us. Until the next storm. So what does P stand for? Say it one more time for me. What does P stand for? Oh, you guys are good. Okay, let me tell you about this book. The secret that I shared with you today is from this book. And the formula that I created for you today is just my own rendition on it. And the reason why I decided to share this today is because on that Thursday morning when I was at my wit's end and I didn't think I could make it, I remember going to my chiropractic appointment. I always go on a Thursday morning at 8:30. And I just remember driving there and I just remember thinking in the car, I don't know what's up there. God, universe, spirit, I'm just so ready. I'm just so ready. I remember saying it out loud. I'm ready. I'm ready for whatever it is that I need to do next. Give me a sign. Give me something, because I'm running on empty over here. And so I remember sitting in my chiropractor's waiting lounge, and there's this book. It's a bit gold. Can you see that? It was just shining at me a little bit. And I remember walking over to it, and I grabbed it off the shelf, and I was reading the back of it, and Think and Grow Rich, written in the 1930s. That's an old book. I remember thinking, I don't know if I want to read that. And I'm flicking through it, and I flick to the first page, and it reads, can you see that? There's a little note there. It reads this: Happy birthday, Dr. Mark. May all your dreams and aspirations be fulfilled, Dr. A. Dr. A is the chiropractor who I sat next to at that day when I went to that money mindset course. Dr. A is the gentleman who introduced me to this business. Dr. A taught my chiropractor how to be a chiropractor. Can you see the magic in that? If that's not a sign from the universe, I don't know what is. I just remember bursting into tears, and I took a photo of it and I sent it to Aunt, and I was just like, oh my God, you'll never believe what's just happened. And so I just want to remind you that we are always being guided. Everything that happens to us happens for us. And I just want to remind you about the magic that is around us. When you're ready to see it, when you're ready to pick it up, when you're ready to observe it, it's there for you. And so I read the book and seemingly found out at the same time that I would be here with you today, and I just couldn't help but share this secret with you, because it's simple. There's four parts to the formula, and we can all remember what they are. So I'm going to ask you to do something for me right now. I want you to place everything that you have on the floor. I don't want anything to be on your lap. I'm going to take you through a process to help you have that vision, to help you embody that future self. And so I want you to close your eyes. I don't want you to think about what the person next to you is doing. And I just want you to take a deep breath in. Now, take a deep breath in through your nose to relax your mind and your body. Breathe out through your mouth and make your breaths long and slow and steady. Don't worry about what anyone else around you is doing or thinking. I want you to tune into you. Release that breath slowly, and when the air is all the way out, then take another deep breath in through your nose. Let your lungs fill up with air, and when you're ready to release, do so slowly again, calmly and peacefully. Now, this time I want you to take a long breath through your nose, and this time I want you to envision the air moving up through your body from the bottom of your spine all the way up into your head like a straw, like you're breathing in air through a straw all the way up into your head, and I want you to hold it for a moment and then release. We're going to do that one last time. Breathe all the way in, up through your body, up your spine like it's a straw, and hold that breath at the top of your head. Envision it swirling around in your head. And with this breath out, I want you to allow all your thoughts, all your mind chatter to leave with this breath out. I want you to now go back to breathing like you normally would. Any thoughts that appear in your mind, think of them like a cloud in the sky. They just appear
but let them pass on by. Allow your mind to be focused on your body, on your breath, and on the present moment. Now, there's a creative intelligence that lives within you, that loves you so very much, that wants the very best for you and your life, and it has the ability to allow you to create whatever it is you want for your life. It has the power to co-create with you your divine destiny. You are a creature of creative being. You are constantly in creation mode. With the power of your thought, your desire, your decision, your imagination, your faith, today you can create a life that is far beyond your wildest imagination. With your action, with your persistence, today is the day you create the life you are worth living for. Now, think about, what is the greatest expression of yourself that you can be? Your future self. Who you know you can be. How would a great person think? How would a great person act? How would such an individual live? How would he or she love? What does greatness feel like? I want you to move into this state of being. It is time to change your energy and broadcast a whole new vibrational frequency. When you change your energy, you change your life. Let the thought become the experience, and let the experience produce an elevated emotion in your heart. What is the greatest expression of yourself? How do you act? How do you love? How do you share? What does your life look like? How does it feel? Come on, you can do this. Let your thought become your experience so that your body emotionally believes that the future you is already living now. Because the truth is, you already have everything within you to be your future self. Move into a new state of being. How would you feel if you were already this person? You can't get up as the same person you were when you sat down. You have to feel so much gratitude for this future version of you, this future life, so that your body begins to change ahead of the actual event. And accept that this new ideal is already you. Become it, breathe it, to be empowered, to be free, to be unlimited, to burn the boats and have a burning desire for more, to make the definite decision that this is it, to have faith. You are worthy and you have what it takes to be creative, to be genius, to be divine. That is who you really are. Once you feel this way, memorize this feeling. Don't ever forget it. Now place your hand on your heart and take a deep breath in. Can you feel your heart beating? You are living as your greatest self. Come on, let's do it again. Can you create yourself out of nothing one more time? Keeping your eyes closed, I want you to slowly stand up. Keep your hand on your heart and stay connected. What is the greatest expression of yourself? Begin to think like this ideal again. What would you say to yourself? How would you walk? How would you breathe? How would you move? How would you live? How would you feel? Allow yourself to emotionally feel like this new self so much that you begin to move into a new state of being. It's time to change your energy again and remember what it feels like to be this person. Expand your heart. Who do you want to be when you open your eyes? Feel empowered once again. Move into a new state of being. You are signaling a new vibration, a new personality, a new personal reality. This is where you create your destiny. From this elevated state of mind and body, it is time to demand your new reality. Feel invincible, powerful, inspired, grateful, and joyful. From this new state of being, I want you to picture an event that you want to experience and let that image become the blueprint of your future. Observe that reality. Where are you? Who are you with? Allow all the possibilities to collapse into your life as an experience. See it, command it, hold it. Let your energy now become entangled with that destiny. That future event has to find you because you created it with your own imagination and your own energy. Let yourself go and create the future you want in certainty, in trust. Knowingness. Don't analyze it. Don't try and figure out how it'll come to happen. That's not your job to control the outcome. It is your task to create and leave the details to a greater mind, a greater intelligence. As you stand here right now as the observer of your future, simply bless your life with your own energy. From a state of gratitude now, be one with your destiny from a new state of mind and body. Give thanks for your new life. Feel how you would feel when you have these things manifest in your life, because living in a state of gratitude is living in a state of receivership. Feel like your prayers are already answered. Finally, it is time to turn to that power within you and ask it for a sign in your life. If today you observed the secret, if you're ready to harness it, if you emulated this greater mind as a creator of your life and you made contact with it, then it should show cause in your life. Know that this is real, that this exists, and now you have a two-way communication with this system. And ask that this sign from this universal intelligence comes to you in a way that you least expect it, that surprises you and leaves no doubt that this new experience has to come in your life. I want you now to ask for a sign. And now, in a moment, when you hear the next song play, I'm going to ask you to bring your awareness back into your body, back to your new mind, to your new environment, and into a whole new line of time. When you hear the next song play, I want you to dance like your future self would dance. I want you to dance like no one is watching, and I want you to be the greatest version of yourself. Act like the greatest version. Show up like the greatest version, because you deserve it.
Thank you. Oh, wow. I think she needs another round of applause, just saying. Come on, let's give it up.